Val says, go ahead, open up the Steam Deck. We have no problem with it, but you might. Let's have a look right after this. Now, there are very few companies out there that actually tell you to go ahead, open up their product, and play around with it. Well, Valve has done just that. Valve has said that their new upcoming Steam Deck, go ahead, if you want to open it up, you want to play with it, have fun. But there's a little warning, and that warning isn't against warranty, because your warranty will still remain intact. They're saying the warning is, you will die. Now, what do they mean exactly by that? They're not going to come after you, but they're saying that there's many little components inside the unit itself that could possibly get damaged, lost. Lots of other things can happen when you deal with something this small, all compact, tightly put together as the Steam Deck and many other small portables as well. The biggest problem is with the battery. Not just this battery, all batteries. If you accidentally damage or hit the internal battery in cell phones or other devices or even the Steam Deck, it could definitely catch on fire. Once it catches on fire, you will catch on fire and you will die. Now, when you open it up and mess with the parts and you damage them, well, of course, they're not going to be, you know, covered by warranty. The damage done to the battery, the unit, everything else is not covered. But simply just opening it up does not void your warranty. In fact, this video that you're watching right now is them showing you what you can do if you want to. They don't recommend it. Go ahead and do whatever you want. Have a look at it, play with it, open it up, make changes, modify it, anything that you need to do with this unit. All good to go, and they're showing you the components. So, is this video to show you how to open it up and play around with it? Maybe. But I think what they're doing instead is they're opening it for all of us so that no one else will have to. Well, that's not really going to stop anyone, because people still will open it up, play around with it, see if they can modify, change the SSD. All of that is replaceable. Will it be supported by the software? Nothing is confirmed yet. But the good news is, if something breaks down, let's say the Wi-Fi adapter doesn't work, the SSD fails, it could potentially be changed, including the thumbsticks. As we know, a lot of controllers from Sony, Microsoft, even Nintendo, actually, especially Nintendo, are prone to stick drift. So if that ever happens with this one, even though they're different, rest assured you can open it up and change them. Hopefully no one ever has to open these components or this device up, because as you can see, there's a lot of small components, and it's only good for those that are willing to take that or have a little bit of experience playing around and repairing electronics. For the rest of us, let's keep our system closed, enjoy it the way it is once it does release, hopefully at the end of this year. If not, definitely sometime next year is what Valve is promising. That's it for this one. Hope you all enjoy. Take care. See you all in the next one.